So we've just looked at the rectangular tool. Now let's look at the oval tool. And basically, what's pretty much the same way. It's kind of like a rubber band. You just click and drag, and you can make ovals or circles if you're really careful. However, if you want to make sure you get perfect circles every time, simply hold down the shift key and it constrains it to a circle so that you can't go wrong. So, circle tool, oval tool. One nice thing to know about the shape tool is that if you create, if you double click to select the stroke and the fill, you can move it around, and as long as shapes are on the same layer, we haven't even talked about layers, so everything you know is on layer one up here. This is similar to your Photoshop layers in a sense. As long as everything is on the same layer, if you click and move this circle on top of an existing shape, then take it away, it cuts right out. So, you know, there's some interesting ways to create negative spaces. You can use that for a number of things. You can just take the fill. Now you'll see that that didn't cut anything because I didn't deselect it. You have to deselect it, so click off of it. Oh, and I've also just illustrated another point, is that they need to be a different color or else you won't be able to select it again. So let's do that again. There we go. And now it's cut out. So let me do that one more time. So if I take a shape of a different color, put it on top of another shape, and move it, nothing happens. But if I put it on top of another shape, deselect, then select it again, and then move it, we can play the cutout game. So that's important to know. It's not necessarily that it has to be a different color, it's just that you have to be able to select it again, because if you deselect it, now you just lost that shape because it merged into the same color. So shapes of different colors will retain their ability to be selected. Shapes with the same color, once deselected, merge into themselves. So that could be it could be a positive, it can be a negative. As long as you know the rules, you shouldn't have any problems. But it can actually be very useful when creating shapes and patterns.